Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the concept of ring algorithm, guys. So this algorithm is also used for election only. Okay, so ring algorithm. So the algorithm applies the system organization as a ring or a train or a chain. Okay, so basically this algorithm is really easy, guys. If you understand the logic behind it, you'll be assuming that, okay, so what is there in this? You'll be thinking in that way. Okay, so assume that this is our distributed network or distributed systems. Okay, so here we are having various systems, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 0. Okay, so our previous leader is 6, guys. Our coordinator is 6. Okay, and this is identified by, okay, and unfortunately 5 and 2 have sent the message to 6, but there is no reply in a time, guys. Okay, so there is no response from 6 in time. So they understood that, okay, there is something fishy with 6. So let us remove him and let us do the election again. Okay. So now initiator being 5 and 2. So let us take first 2 as an initiator, guys. So initiator is someone who just adds his number into a list and sends the message. So as you observe the blue line, guys. So blue line is of 2 and green line is of 5, guys. So if 5 initiated, this will be the result, and 2 initiated, this blue line will be the result. Okay. So 2 initiated. So it will be creating a list and pushing its value into the list. So 2 has been pushed. So now it visited 3. So 3 is not there in the list. So 3 is also pushed. Okay. Similarly, it is moved, pushed forward. So 2, 3, 4. Again pushed forward. 2, 3, 4, 5. Again pushed forward. 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. Again pushed forward. 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 0. Again pushed forward. 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 0, 1. Okay. Again pushed forward. If you notice here, it is again reached into starting spot. So now in the list, who is the maximum? 7 is the maximum. So he will be elected as a new leader. Simple, right? Yes. So that is the concept of ring algorithm, guys. So similarly, the same situation with 5. So with 5, he will be initiating the election. He'll be adding his number into list, pushing it. Pushing it. So 5, 5, 7, 5, 7, 0, 5, 7, 1, 5, 7, 1, 2, 5, 7, 0, 1, 2, 3. 5, okay, so here you might be having a doubt that, okay, so it will send also for this also. It will send, but there is no response from here. So it is automatically, it is an non-reachable state, you can say in that way, okay? Yes. So at the end, 7 got the leadership, right? So 5 and 2 will be intimating everyone that 7 is the new leader. Got it? Yes. So that is the concept of ring algorithm, guys, okay? So let us go through the theory. Okay, so this algorithm applied to system organized as a ring or a train or a chain. Okay, so the algorithm states that when a node notices that the coordinator is dead, it builds and sends an election message. So that message is called as election message, guys. Okay, so at every step, nodes keep on adding its own ID to the end of the list. Okay, so the process stops when the sender or the initiator receives the message, it sent. So whoever sent it, if they received it, the process will stop, guys. Okay, so after this, the node with the highest ID is declared as the coordinator. So in the list, whoever is having the highest ID, he will be the leader. That's it. Okay, so initiator announces the coordinator by sending the message to all the nodes. So here how 2 and 5 sent to everyone. So that is the process, guys. Okay. So one more thing that you should remember is there will be a ring shape and it will be in a flow, guys. In a one-way flow. It should not be in opposite and opposite like that. So it will be a single way flow. Okay. Yes. So I hope everyone got a clear idea on this mutual exclusion and ring concept, that is nothing but the election algorithms. So in the next lecture, we'll be starting with a new topic that is nothing but about consistency. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching.